I'm the one that was brought up last or 2 weeks ago regarding the broker that represents 7 tenants. That would be me. So I want to make sure that I'm the face, even though nobody named me. So years ago, I was brought on to this project when I worked for Ethan Conrad. I probably did 9 or 10 leases when I was trying to basically save this project that was vacant. There was nothing going on over here, and there was no pulse. I worked with Daryl Doan and tried to get life going into this property and bring it to where there was a community. I worked hard to bring these tenants in here. And if anybody doesn't know or understand what it takes to be a small business owner, I'm happy to fill you in at another time. So I just want to come forward and tell you guys that I've been working diligently with these tenants since I got a call from Flaming Grill back in January when all this hit the news media and when their businesses started taking a hit because of all this media attention and nobody talked to them from the hospitals. I've been in contact with the hospital for months. I've sent them termination agreements. I've sent them potential relocations. I had relocations set up for every single one of these tenants. I've even had a tenant that just wanted to walk away, and they said, you know what? She walks away, they're just going to come after her, and they're going to seek money. And then they went silent on me. They've been ghosting me. So this whole thing about, hey, we're here for the tenants and we're trying to help the tenants is a flat-out lie. I have documentation on all of it. I'm happy to bring in every single email to you guys and let you know that this is not true. And I would be concerned because, to me, for somebody to come up here and blatantly lie to city council and everybody in here and these tenants and try and portray themselves as, hey, we're trying to do the right thing, they have not. And I'm going to tell you, I'm going to stand in the truth and I'm going to stand in the light. I have a reputation around town. You can call anybody out there in the community, and my word is my bond. So I want you guys to be aware of that. I tried to do something right for Elk Grove, and to turn around and see that these tenants are being taken advantage of. This is their livelihood. This is how they pay their bills, pay their rent, pay for their child to go to school, you take care of their parents. And to see these people that have put everything into these businesses and to have total disregard for that and just get thrown under the bus because Mike is adamant for making sure that these people go out of business and they don't have to drop a dime. And yet they're here asking for $900 million, and he's going to sit in here and balk for the fact of a relocation cost. So I suggest that you guys table this whole thing and come back to it maybe in a month when we can reevaluate the whole situation. That's all I've got for you for today. But I will be breaking down a timeline of everything that's gone on because I want you to be educated when you make decisions. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ms. Snyder.
Come on back, please.
Would you please leave your contact information? Oh, we have an email. Okay, never mind. I'd like to reach out and speak with you, please.
I sent you guys all an email, but I'm happy to. I'll give you my cell phone.